Tamil Nadu is going through a bad phase. We have seen farmers of Tamil Nadu in Delhi for more than 38 days. They have been struggling to make a point, to ask for their loan waivers, to ask for the drought relief. And the type of problems Tamil Nadu is facing because of drought, there is no drinking water, farmers are committing suicide, general masses are finding it difficult. But at the same time, it is shameful that the government is totally insensitive to their issues. The central government, the Bharatiya Janata Party-led Modi government, on one hand, is trying to play all politics in Tamil Nadu to ensure a backdoor entry, to ensure a backdoor interference. But at the same time, PM Modi has no time to meet the farmers who've been protesting in Delhi, to the extent that the farmers were forced to make a point to catch his attention when naked, removed their clothes and demonstrated. And today they have said that they are going to consume their own urine, which is so unfortunate. But still, the Prime Minister does not have time to listen to the farmers, to meet the farmers. It is very unfortunate, and we condemn it in the strongest of words that he has no time to listen to the woes of the farmers, the drug issue, the loan waiver issue. But at the same time, whether it be Amit Shah, whether it be Mr. Modi, they are trying to play politics in Tamil Nadu to grab power back door, as they have always done since they have come to power. Whether it be in Uttarakhand, we have seen, whether it be in Arunachal Pradesh, whether it be in Manipur or Goa, we have seen how, setting aside all democratic values, the BJP has grabbed power, and now their new playground is Tamil Nadu. But they are not worried about the farmers who are dying, the plight of a common man in Tamil Nadu. They are not bothered. The only concern is to grab power in Tamil Nadu, which is so unfortunate. So we condemn the attempt of the Modi government to grab power in Tamil Nadu through backdoors, and the way they are neglecting the issues of Tamil Nadu. The Prime Minister does not have the time to meet the farmers who have been protesting for this long, has no time to address their problems and the problems of the Tamil people of Tamil Nadu. As far as Mahila Congress is concerned, we are working hard, and this is not the first and the last such celebration which we are having in Tamil Nadu. We will have a series of such celebration in various divisions of Tamil Nadu, and we will celebrate Hindraji's contribution to the nation. We will celebrate her ideas, her vision for the country, which took us a long way, which made us stronger, which helped make India a place globally. So we are here to celebrate that great leader of ours. Any questions if you want to ask? We are celebrating it throughout the country. We are once again paying our respect to Indraji for her contribution in making of this country. She was not only a great leader of the country, but globally recognized as a strong and great leader. So we are here to celebrate her birth anniversary, 100th birth anniversary. As far as Tamil Nadu is concerned, we know Tamil Nadu is going through a bad phase. We have seen farmers of Tamil Nadu in Delhi for more than 38 days. They have been struggling to make a point, to ask for their loan waivers, to ask for the drought relief. And the type of problems Tamil Nadu is facing because of drought, there is no drinking water, farmers are committing suicide, general masses are finding it difficult. But at the same time, it is shameful that the government is totally insensitive to their issues. The central government, the Bharatiya Janata Party-led Modi government, on one hand is trying to play all politics in Tamil Nadu to ensure a backdoor entry, to ensure a backdoor interference, but at the same time, PM Modi has no time to meet the farmers who've been protesting in Delhi to the extent that the farmers were forced to make a point to catch his attention when naked, removed their clothes and demonstrated, and today they have said that they are going to consume their own urine, which is so unfortunate. But still, the Prime Minister does not have time to listen to the farmers, to meet the farmers. It is very unfortunate, and we condemn it in the strongest of words that he has no time to listen to the woes of the farmers, the drought issue, the loan waiver issue. But at the same time, whether it be Amit Shah, whether it be Mr. Modi, they are trying to play politics in Tamil Nadu to grab power back door, as they have always done since they have come to power. Whether it be in Uttarakhand, we have seen, whether it be in Arunachal Pradesh, whether it be in Manipur or Goa, we have seen how setting aside all democratic values, the BJP has grabbed power, and now their new playground is Tamil Nadu. But they are not worried about the farmers who are dying, the plight of a common man in Tamil Nadu, they are not bothered. The only concern is to grab power in Tamil Nadu, which is so unfortunate. So we condemn the attempt of the Modi government to grab power in Tamil Nadu through backdoors, and the way they are neglecting the issues of Tamil Nadu. The Prime Minister does not have the time to meet the farmers who have been protesting for this long, has no time to address their problems and the problems of the Tamil people of Tamil Nadu. As far as Mahila Congress is concerned, we are working hard, and this is not the first and the last such celebration which we are having in Tamil Nadu. We will have a series of such celebration in various divisions of Tamil Nadu, and we will celebrate Hindraji's contribution to the nation. We will celebrate her ideas, her vision for the country, which took us a long way, which made us stronger, which helped make India a place globally. So we are here to celebrate that great leader of ours. Any questions if you want to ask? As far as Mahila Congress is concerned, as far as Congress is concerned, Congress has always vouched for women's empowerment, whether it be social, economic, or political. It was the vision of Rajiv Gandhiji which got us reservation in the local bodies. 33% reservation was enhanced by Rajivji in the local bodies, which was later enhanced to 50% by the in the UP government. 33% was enhanced to 50%, and now India is the only country which has 50% reservation for women at the local level. But as far as assembly and parliament are concerned, the dream of Rajivji still remains incomplete. Congress has been working towards it. When we had our government at the center, though we did not have the numbers in the Lok Sabha, we had numbers in the Rajya Sabha, and we passed the Women's Reservation Bill in the Rajya Sabha. But the BJP government in its manifesto promised the women of this country that once they come to power, they will pass the Women's Reservation Bill. It's been 3 years that the BJP is in absolute power in the Lok Sabha, but they have not bothered to table the Women's Reservation Bill. It has proved to be one of the jumlas of the BJP, as other old promises which they have put into the dustbin. Likewise, they have put the Women's Reservation Bill also in the dustbin. But as Mahila Congress cadre, we all have determined to fight the BJP tooth and nail to ensure that they table this bill. We will fight this government out. and ensure that they table this bill and pass it in the Lok Sabha so that it becomes a reality that we get 33% reservation in state assemblies and parliament as well.